Hello everyone, this is Dr. Bruce B. Baird, and you're listening to the Productive Dentist Podcast, the podcast that focuses on productivity in today's dental practice and explores my experiences over the last 39 years. Our goal is to give you the choices that productivity allows: more time for the things you love doing, increased take-home pay, better team relationships, and lower stress in practice. We will help with not just strategies, but real-life examples that have helped thousands of dentists over the last 30 years. Welcome to the Productive Dentist Podcast. This is episode 2. Looking forward to sharing with everyone the topic, stress in the dental practice, elimination of stress in the dental practice. Let me ask you a question. Are you highly productive when you're stressed out? How about when your team's stressed out? Are you productive? Does productivity go up or does productivity go down? Well, I think we know the answer to that. It goes down. And why is that? Well, you know, stress is one of those things. Everybody has stress in their life. And what I try to talk to my team about and what I try to talk to patients about is something that I call training opportunities. If I have a patient that comes in and, oh, for whatever reason, they're upset about something, upset about something in the dental practice. Used to be, I would think that they were just a butthead. You know, what the hell are they griping about? But the truth is, sometimes one of our systems in our practice breaks down. And it's smart to actually try to figure out exactly what that is that's bothering them. And is it something that you have done? Or are they just a butthead? So what I call that is a training opportunity. Back years ago, when I did a little intro to this whole podcast, but you know, I wasn't the best boss in the world. When something didn't go right, I would throw my little temper tantrum or whatever. I didn't throw instruments, but I would roll my eyes, I would sigh, and it didn't lead to conducive. It wasn't conducive to taking great care of patients or taking great care of my team. Jokingly, you know, I talk about having four daughters and I had to learn to speak a different language. But the part of this that really makes the difference is looking at it as a training opportunity. So let's just say you have one team member that doesn't set the tray up correctly, you know, on an ongoing basis. Now, I could roll my eyes. I could tell them, look, you need to start doing it this way or you're going to be fired, my way or the highway. And that worked really well because I had a lot of people take the highway years ago. But it's not the best thing to do. So what I would do is I would dedicate, now that we have cell phones, I just put a little note in my cell phone that says, Mary is having trouble with this. And so when I have a break between patients or I'm working between patients, I'll just say, hey, Mary, let's take a look at this. You know, these setups, I really need to have them like this, okay? And I know you're an awesome assistant, giving out some compliments, which is something that I never used to do, but I do that all the time now. I don't want it to be an attack on their skill level. Sometimes, you know, yes, they're brand new. I have one assistant that used to work at a vet, one that used to work at Walmart, and they've been with me cumulative over 50 years. Why? Well, they like abuse. That's possible. Or you know, I had to change, and we began looking at these things as training opportunities. Let's say a lab case is not back. You know, we can go through a million different scenarios, but I call those training opportunities. And why do I want to train my team? Well, first of all, the more I train my team, the less I have to do, the less I have to be involved in every little procedure that goes on the practice. If you want to be productive, you need to have your team, you know, working on all cylinders around you. And I love the fact that my team now, when I walk into the office, everything's there. Patients have been confirmed. Everyone is ready for the day. They know what is coming in. They know who their patients are. And we'll talk more about that when I talk about scheduling. But having your team train, having your patients trained, when they're late for, you know, it's stressful when a patient's always late for appointments. They're late for an appointment, and it gets you behind. Well, I address that, and I address that with the patient in a very crucial conversation. And I usually will say something like, Bob, you know, we're going to go ahead and get this done today, but you know, I really would appreciate it if in the future you try to get here on time. I know the traffic and everything else, but it really sets us back. And I want to help you, and we're going to get it done today, so don't worry about it. But I'm speaking directly to that person. I had one guy that he owned a car wash, and he used to miss his appointments. He was a buddy of mine, and so the dentist friends are the worst. And he would miss an appointment with hygiene, no big deal, just call up an hour before or not even call. And finally, I said, I tell you what, let me do this. Is it okay if I rent out your car wash for about an hour? And he was like, oh, yeah, that'd be awesome. He said, you can bring all the whole team down and everybody can get their car washed and detailed. I said, absolutely, that'd be great. He said, yeah, that's awesome. And I said, but we're not going to show up. And he looked at me and said, what do you mean? I said, no, we're really not going to show up. We're going to set an appointment for an hour with you, and then we're not going to show up. And he went, oh, I get it. I said, yeah, you know, I'm paying this team. I'm paying these people. And when you don't show up, it's coming out of my pocket. So that's a crucial conversation to have with a friend. But you know what? He never missed any appointments after that. He was always on time. He always called. That is the relationship, not rapport. And relationship is an agreed upon course of action between two parties. And rapport is just high fives. And dentists have a big tendency to do a lot of high fives and very little be in relationship with the patients. So those are some of the things that I look at. Let's look at other things that, you know, maybe a patient might do to create stress. Well, one thing is they say bad things to the team, and then you walk in and it's like you're the savior. You know, they're griping, bitching, and moaning, and then all of a sudden you walk in and they go, oh, hi, Dr. Baird, how are you? It's so good to see you. Well, I actually will have a crucial conversation with him. I said, you know what, Mary? I said, this is crazy, but my whole team is afraid of you. And the patient will go, what? I said, yeah. They said that when you come in, sometimes you're kind of irritated and angry, and gosh, I just want you to know that this is my family. These are my kids and my friends' kids, and this is, I'm, you know, this is my family. This is my team. And they go, oh, I'm so sorry. And they will apologize. Then you know what? They become the best patients. And if not, you don't need them in the practice anyway. You know, that's a true measure of success, is when you can reduce stress in your office where everyone's having fun. And, you know, I used to do this. I would roll out. If I heard people laughing in the office, I would roll out into the hallway in my chair and go, shh, you guys be quiet. You know, this is a professional office. You know, we can't do that. And what was funny about it is, hey, it is, you know, I'd rather be in an environment that was fun. I talk at the seminars about the smiley face and frowny face in the break room. And I came in, and every day for about 3 years, I'd see this big old smiley face, big old frowny face, and I didn't pay much attention to it. And one day I just said, well, what is this smiley face, frowny face? And they said, oh, you need to talk to Gay. So I went to Gay, and Gay said, well, you need to talk to Emily. And I went and talked to Emily, and Emily said, well, that's you. Every morning when you walk in the back, we decide whether you're in a good mood or a bad mood. Wow. You're talking about something that hit me right between the eyes. That helped me change. You know, if you sit and listen on the radio to talk news and so-and-so killed so-and-so and they found so-and-so and all of these things, you know, it's easy to get depressed about, you know, just what's going on. I prefer now to listen to some music on the way to the office, something that's uplifting. When I get to the office, I am in a mode where this is fun time for me. I'm going to enjoy my patients. I am going to be productive today. I'm not going to let my behavior affect my entire office. And let me tell you, that happens every single day in the dental practice. I've watched it with associates, and I've watched it as we've trained and taught over 2,000 dental offices over the last 15 years. So it's something that we see on an ongoing basis. It's got to be something that, as a leader in the practice, you've got to come to work ready to go, just as your team has to come ready to go. If you've got a dental assistant that is, you know, supposed to be seeing a patient with you, and they don't know everything that's going to be done in that procedure, that's not my place, although I do know, because I go through and review. Why do I review my schedule for the next day. I look at every single patient that's coming in the next day so I know exactly what I'm doing. Why do I do that? Because I want to be efficient. And efficient's not about speed. I want to remember the stories. I want to remember where they were. They were on a cruise. I want to remember that Bob did this or Mary did this or Joe did that. That leads to a great productive day. But if my team member who is actually seeing that patient doesn't know what all we're doing, then I put that on them. And so I help train that. That's a training opportunity. I said, don't ever come in the room, and we'll say this in our team meetings, don't ever come in the room and come get me unless you're prepared for exactly what have been in the patient notes and everything else. And now, again, we're going to have several episodes on just scheduling, but scheduling makes a huge difference in how I put, you know, each treatment coordinator or each dental assistant, and I have them with their own chair, with their own production number. I don't compare production one to the other, but what I do is I make sure that they know that that's their schedule. And they better know. They may have 6 patients, 7 patients that day, but you better know everything about that patient. And so those are the things that we do to try and create less stress. So if something happens that stresses me out, stresses my team out, or stresses patients out, instead of me throwing the temper tantrum, what I do is I call that the training opportunity. And that's when we talk about it. I talk to the patient about it, because what I don't want is I don't want it to ever happen again. Does it? Yeah, it'll happen again. And what do? It's another training opportunity. When I first started Granbury Dental Center 34 years ago, my goal was to be a model practice. I wanted to have the model type practice. Well, unfortunately, I was seeing 300 new patients a month, which is unfortunate, but fortunate because I had a big note at the bank. We also happened to be on the road from the nuclear power plant about 8 miles down the road where they had 15,000 employees. So I saw a bunch of new patients. A full mouth exam for me was a mouth mirror. You know, get an x-ray. We only had one x-ray machine. It was in the middle of the office. We'd have a line for people going in there. I wanted it to be awesome experience to come to the dental office in our practice. And like I said in the intro, we did $1 million in our first year in practice, and I took home $32,000. Well, that's stress. That's high stress. I was working 8 in the morning to 8 o'clock at night every single day, working on Saturdays, plus doing administrative tasks. So I understand where you're at. If you're just doing a startup practice or you're beginning in your career, man, there's just not enough time. Being productive and reducing stress is one of those things that if you do early, you're going to notice massive changes in your long-term benefit. It's going to be a big deal. And as we go through that, and as we work with our team, and as we work with our patients, and we work on ourselves, all of a sudden we start to become the kind of dental practice that I think you probably have always envisioned or dreamed about. And that's the one where you show up, your patients are confirmed, everyone knows what's going on that patient that day. You know, your team knows, the front office knows, everybody's clicking on the same notes, and you're looking at everything the same way. That can increase productivity significantly. And remember, productivity is not about how fast you do things. Productivity is about being able to communicate with your patients. And how do you communicate with patients? Well, if it's stressed and you're rolling your eyes and you're walking in, my first introduction to every single patient that I ever saw, probably the first 2 years, I'd come in, I'd say, hi, my name's Dr. Baird. I'm so sorry I'm running behind. Because once you start running behind, and that's a whole conversation, I would guess that 90%, maybe 95% of the dentists in the country run behind. And they try to catch up during lunch, and then they try to catch up at the end of the day, and it's just whenever the day's finished is the time to go home. That's stressful. That's extremely stressful. And it's one of those things where we're going to work through scheduling, and we're going to work through communication skills and complex treatment planning and team meetings, same-day dentistry. We're going to go through all of that, but you can't do any of those things if you're running behind. And that's where scheduling and a true understanding by your team is going to make that huge, huge difference in the future. But what about stress? Well, every time something stresses you out, your team out, or your patients out, take it serious. If you're stressed out about something, address it then. Do it in a nice way. Take great care of your people. But you have to tell them what you need to have done. You have to share with them, this is the type of practice that we want to have. It's so interesting that I haven't had to fire anybody in years because my team is so committed. They're so uncommon when it comes to their day-to-day operations that they love being in control of their schedule, being in control of things, including calling and confirming their own patients. All of these things are stuff that we're going to be talking about in the future. So that's the podcast on stress. You're going to hear me talk a lot about stress over the life of this podcast. So, but take it serious. Come set and ready to go. Remember, this is Dr. Bruce B. Baird, the Productive Dentist, signing off. But before I do, make sure you go to our website, ProductiveDentistPodcast.com. Give us a like, and we look forward to sharing some more information with you on our next podcast.